Hi, my name is Subjit Singh. I'm a graduate certificate student in hospitality management. Today I'm going to give the presentation on human resource management. Here, I would like to start from my career path. After completing my grad cert, I would like to go for a placement in a hotel or restaurant as a waiter or as a housekeeper, because it is the basic position in a hotel where I can get the knowledge about all hotel. And after 5 years, I would like to see myself as a front office assistant or a supervisor. And by the 2020, I would like to see myself as a general manager. I would like to go for a hotel Marriott because it's a big hotel chain and it has branches in India where I'm basically from. So I can get a job back in India as well if I go for the hotel Marriott. Hotel Marriott mainly give a full-time contract, but it also give the part-time contract as well. The full-time contract is given to those persons who are at managerial level basically, and because they need those persons for continuously making the policies and procedure of the industry. And here I would like to recommend that hotel should give a part-time contract as well, like for the special occasions, so like the coming near Olympic, so they need extra staff for that event. After that period, they can get rid of their staff and save the money as well. And here I would like to recommend that they should recruit only, not only, but mainly the young staff, because hotel is the industry where people need to work for longer hours. Only the young persons can afford that much of work, and the staff should be properly qualified, because London is the main tourist area, and all over the world people come here to visit. If the staff will be qualified, they can give the better services to the customers. The next is the management recruitment process. To recruit the persons, first of all, the Marriott identified the requirement, that what type of persons they need, and they set the objectives and job descriptions, that what are the requirement of what should be the qualification of the persons and the experience, and then they advertise the vacancy. It can be advertised through the internal or external sources. Internal sources can be the company's website, and external sources are like newspaper and other media as well. Then after getting the pool of application, they shortlist the candidate and call for him for the interview. And after the interview, the successful candidates are called for the induction, where they have been given the basic knowledge about the hotel. The next is the learning and development strategy. In the learning and development strategy, we do the basically the training and to try to develop the knowledge of the newly recruited people. Like during this process, we identify the objectives of the training and like what we want to achieve, and we select the trainees, persons whom we need to give the training. Here the training method is more important, like what type of training method should be given. Here I would like to recommend that persons should be given on the job training, because during the job he can get the knowledge about the industry with more frequently, because he will be working as well and he is getting training as well. The Marriott provider is separate mentor to the new recruit persons, whom they call buddy, and he give proper knowledge about the industry to those persons. And after that, they evaluate the training program, that have they achieved the proper target of training or not. If they haven't achieved the target, they just go for the reason and try to improve that. The next is the policies and procedures of Marriott. Like what type of policies and procedures Marriott is following. There are some basic policies which are like health and safety, security, harassment free workplace, protection of Marriott hotel and asset, equal opportunity. Every person should be aware of these policies and procedures, because these are very essential for the hotel as well as for the employees' sake. because on the basis of these policies and procedures, they can do claim on each other if any party do anything wrong. Here I would like to recommend that the company should give a separate session for these policies and procedures, so like a separate induction. And after the induction, they should be checked through the exam, like have they got the main points of the policies and procedures. If they haven't got, then they should be given the extra time to learn these policies and procedures. The next one is the performance management strategy of Marriott. Here we establish the performance standard, like what should be the performance of an employee, and we measure that performance. According to the set standard, we measure that employee have achieved that standard or not. If he haven't achieved that standard, we try to find why he hasn't achieved that standard, and we discuss that with the employee, and we take the necessary actions which are required for the proper performance of the employees. Here I would like to recommend that management should introduce some reward system as well, like if an employee do a good performance, then he should be given a promotion, or he should be given an extra bonus, or there should be increase in salary. If the Marriott gives like this reward system, the employee will try to make himself more upgrade and try to do more work with more loyalty. And here's the last step of the human resource management, is the exit strategy for the Marriott. The exit strategy means like when the employee leave the company, employee need to give the resignation. The resignation should be in a written form, and there are also some exit points, like the employee is getting retirement, or it can be redundantry, or if he do any misconduct, or the employee has a poor performance, he can exit the organization. For the exit, human resource department review the resignation of the person, or the review the situations, and then he go for the general manager to review the extra point, or to discuss that if they need this employee, they can give him some extra reward, like a promotion, etc. But if he is not good for the company, then they do not need to give him extra thing, or they just want to get rid of him, and they just accept the resignation and collect the company's asset and just give him his full salary, P45 form or whatever is required by the law. Here I would like to recommend that the employees who are leaving the organization, they should be conducted the exit interviews, because it is very important for the company, because the company can know the reason why that employee is exiting, so they can stop the labor turnover as well. Here I would like to recommend that company should appoint some third party or any computer software for the exit interview, because if they do himself the exit interview, the employee is not going to give the full knowledge. So there should be an anonymity, like there should not be identity disclosure of the employee, so that he can give the proper feedback why he is going to exit the organization. And here I would like to recommend that the company should make a alumni portal as well, where the older employee can keep in contact, so that if the company need their help, they can contact them, and as well as the new recruit can get the knowledge about the industry from those previous employees. That's all for my slides. Thank you very much.